Good morning, students. So today I am going to start new chapter, Biodiversity and its Conservation. First, I am going to explain what is biodiversity. There are various types of organisms present around us. Some are very small, like bees, ants and insects, and some are very large, like elephant, banyan trees, etc. Some organisms are so small that they cannot be seen by naked eyes. This variety in the shape, form and nature of different organisms constitute biodiversity. So as a definition, the term biodiversity refers to the totality of genes, species and ecosystems of a region. Now I am going to explain about the levels of biodiversity. Biological diversity includes three levels. These are genetic diversity, species diversity, and community and ecosystem diversity. These levels of biodiversity are interrelated because genetic diversity is the primary cause of diversity. It gives rise to variation in species. The diversity of species finally leads to the variation of community and ecosystem. So in the given picture, you can see there are three levels of diversity: genetic diversity, species diversity, and community and ecosystem diversity. So first, I am going to discuss about the genetic diversity. The number and nature of genes determine the characters of the organisms. No two individuals have exactly the same genetic makeup. The genetic difference may in number or in the nature of alleles or in the type of genes or in the chromosomal structures. Genetic diversity within a species often increases with environmental variability. So there are three factors for genetic diversity. These factors are mutation, crossing over during gamete formation, and random sexual mating. Second level of biodiversity is species diversity. A species is a group of similar individuals which are able to interbreed and produce fertile hybrids. All the members of a particular species have almost similar characters, but they differ markedly from the members of another species. This variation in the members of two different species in a region is called species diversity. Usually, species diversity is evaluated in a particular region or area. In this sense, the species diversity refers to the varieties of species in a region. Now, the third level of biodiversity is ecological diversity. Genetic and species diversities finally give rise to ecological diversity. It refers to the diversity at the level of ecosystem and community. Ecosystem diversity describes the number of niches, trophic levels, and various ecological processes that support energy flow, food webs, and the recycling of nutrients. It focuses on various biotic interactions, the rate and function of keystone species. In the given picture, you can see there are three levels of biodiversity: genetic diversity, species diversity, and community and ecosystem diversity. Now I am going to discuss about the conservation of biodiversity. So biodiversity is very important for us and for the proper balance of nature. Therefore, it becomes necessary for us to protect our biodiversity. We also have a moral duty to look after our planet and pass it on in a good health to our future generations. We should not deprive the future generations from the economic and aesthetic benefits that they can derive from biodiversity. So there are two strategies of biodiversity conservation. Number one is in situ conservation strategies, and number two is ex situ conservation strategies. As I told you, strategies of biodiversity conservation. So first strategy is in situ conservation strategies. The in situ strategies involves the protection of total ecosystem, that is conservation of species in their natural environment. For this, several protected areas, biosphere reserves, sacred forests and lakes have been recognized, which include a group of typical ecosystem. So protected areas and biosphere reserves, these are two aspects of in situ conservation strategies. In the given picture, you can see a biosphere reserve. So biosphere reserve consists of three zones. Number one, core zone. Number two, buffer zone. And number three, transition zone. So number one, the core zone, it is the inner central part that comprises an undisturbed and legally protected ecosystem. Then number two, buffer zone, it lies in the middle and surrounds the core zone. It is managed to accommodate a greater variety of resources and support educational activities and researches. Number three, transition zone, it is the outermost part of the biosphere reserve. In this zone, there is active cooperation between the reserve management and the local people, and activities like settlement, cropping, forestry, recreation, etc. continue to take place. Next strategies of biodiversity conservation is ex situ conservation strategies. The ex situ conservation strategies include the conservation of biodiversity in artificially developed areas. These areas are botanical gardens, zoological parks, storage of seeds, pollen and tissue cultures, and gene or DNA banks. Next, I am going to explain about hotspots of biodiversity. Hotspots of biodiversity are the designated priority areas for in situ conservation of biodiversity. The concept of hotspots was developed by Norman Mayers in 1988. Important criteria for determining a hotspot are number of endemic species and degree of threat. There are 25 terrestrial hotspots have been identified worldwide. 16 hotspots are in the tropical region. Among the 25 hotspots of the world, 2 are found in India. These are Western Ghats and Eastern Himalayas. In the biodiversity, there are 4 important terms. These are Red Data Book, IUCN, Cryopreservation, and Ramsar Sites. So you can see the definition in the given slide. of these important terms.